हेलो एंड गुड मॉर्निंग, आई होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग वेल। सो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम मिस्टर पृथ्वीराज, आई एम योर फिजिक्स टीचर। टुडे वी विल लर्न व्हाट इज फोर्स, योर फर्स्ट चैप्टर, स्टैंडर्ड 8। सो बिफोर वी गेट इनटू फोर्स एंड ऑल दिस कॉन्सेप्ट्स, लेट मी टेल यू समथिंग अबाउट द ब्रांचेस ऑफ साइंस। बिकॉज यू आर इन हाई स्कूल, so in your childhood you people were learning physical science, biological science or science, right? But in high school, from 8th, you will have clear distinction of your science book, that is your branches of science. So here, as you all can see, introduction to science, what are the branches of science. Students, science is divided into two basic branches, the entire science concept in your school life. One is physical science, other one is biological science. As you can see, physical science and biological science, you have two books as well, physical science book as well as biological science book. In this physical science book, you will have further division, that is physics and chemistry. And again, in your biological science, you are having two divisions, that is botany and zoology. So students, what you need to remember is, sir, what exactly is physics? What exactly is chemistry? Students, before we get into what is physical science, then physical science is not equal to physics. Okay, it is little bit, like it is different. Physical science deals with all the non-living parts, their matter, their size, their physical actions, their phenomena. These all things will be considered under physical science. When we talk about biological science, it deals with the structure, functions of living things like plants and animals, as well as some microorganisms, right? So let me give you some clear distinction. Physics, a branch of science which deals with all the physical entities and the phenomena of this universe, light, scattering, force, then your displacement, distance, running, everything, these kind of concepts, kilometers, meters, these all things comes under physics. It deals with physical entities as well as physical phenomena, right? Chemistry is another branch of science. It is the branch of science which deals with the structure, the functions, the chemical properties, the physical properties of every particles, of every matter, right? Next, biological science is the branch of science which deals with all the living things, irrespective of plant and animals. All the living things, if you are reading about them, that will be your biological science. So students, biological science has further two divisions. First one is botany, second one is zoology. It's a broad distinction, okay? Up to your graduation, you will go in this manner only. So what exactly is botany? Botany is a branch of biological science which deals with all the plants, all the microorganisms, not all the microorganisms, some of like algae and all. Zoology is the other branch of biological science which deals with all the animals, the function of animals, right? Human, a dog, as well as a lion, these all things, okay, these things need to be dealt, and they comes under zoology. When we talk about botany, it will deal with all the plants, flowers, fruits, plants, etc., etc. So this is what I want to say you about. So whenever in this particular chapter, from here, one task I would love to give you. In your physical science book, you need to divide what all chapters comes under physics and what all chapters comes under chemistry. You need to divide it. The same goes for biological science. In biological science as well, you need to differentiate which all chapters comes under botany and which all chapter comes under what? Zoology. This is your primary task for you all. Now we will get into subject. So I would like to congratulate you that you have successfully passed your 7th class exam irrespective of all the adversaries, all the hardships, toughest situations. You people have successfully given your exam at your house, and thanks to our management team, our principal ma'am and all, they have done a lot of hard work, okay, to conduct your exams and all. Now you people are in 8th class. Students, we are dealing a lot of issues. We are dealing with pandemic, we are dealing with war, we are dealing with economic recession, a lot of things are going on. But the primary thing is future of you all, future of yours, especially our school and irrespective of our school, every student. So madam and our senior teachers, they have planned to do something for you all guys. They have done a lot of hard work for you all guys. We are recording for you, like it is we love to do this job, but the initiation was very difficult and we have taken it. Why did to educate you all, okay, to make your this academic year successful, right? So students, what you need to do, the toughest work is to make your house a school, right? You need to make your home a school. You need to be disciplined, because we all are not with you to guide you and to do a lot of stuff, right? So now onwards, please get ready with your pen, pencils, compass, notebook, textbook for every subject. For my subject, you will always see this book, Physical Science. It is a little bit dusty, okay? This is your class 8 Physical Science. You can get it on the internet, you can download it. Okay, it is very easy. You don't need, like, for instance, you can buy this one. And books, you need to come to school and please fetch your books. Okay, so let's get started. Now, the chapter name is Force. Students, chapter 1 Physical Science, Force. Listen carefully, very important chapter for your entire academic, for your upcoming classes as well. This chapter will play an important role, okay? So you need to pay close attention, okay? Get ready. Students, before we go towards force, before we get into force chapter, I need to tell you some things. What all things we will learn in this particular chapter? In what way we will learn, what all things we will learn, okay? How it will help us, these all things we will go to get into. First, you will learn the definition, that is what is force. We will tell you types of force. Division which you will like very much. Then you people will learn net force, okay? Then you people will learn the effects of force. Effects of force means, because of force, what all things can happen, what all things are happening, okay? So, what is force, types of force, net force, effects of force? Before we get into all these concepts, first we need to learn from where this term came, who coined this this particular term first, why we are calling it force, from where it came from, right? Students, we can observe many changes around us. We can observe many changes around us. Like what are changes? Changes in the season, changes during sunrise, changes during sunset, okay? Changes in the tides of a sea. We can see many of the changes, okay? and lot of us thinks that there is an invisible force which control these things, like not us, but in ancient times everybody were thinking that these all things were happening because of some invisible force. Why to talk about like history? Talk about us also. Here today also, lot of us things are, lot of things are happening because of some invisible force. Later humanity developed. We have introduced lot of scientific entities, and now this force, the concept of force, was only limited to explain our efforts. Before it was explaining lot of things because we have lot of misconceptions, but now onwards force will explain only the efforts made by you. Suppose I'll give you some examples. For instance, you are riding a bicycle, you are pushing the pedal down, your main motive is to push the pedal downwards, and what is the work? The bicycle is moving forward and you are coming upward, both of the things are happening, so you are putting an effort, right? Lifting a bag, I am lifting a school bag. Lifting a school bag, you are putting an effort against the gravity. You are lifting the bag and you are holding it on your shoulder and you are coming to school, right? This is an effort. When we talk about door, somebody has to pull the door or somebody has to push the door. There also you are putting some effort. Okay, so what exactly this word effort? Effort, strength, power, force, they all are having like the synonyms, having the same explanation, that is force. Effort, strength, power, force. In English vocabulary, they may have different explanation, but in science, they all are pointing us towards one word, that is force. I hope you are paying close attention to each and every word whatever I spoke. Okay? Now, definition. What is force? Let me erase everything. What is force? Force is nothing but a push or a pull on a body. This is the definition for you. A push or a pull on a body is called as force. Let me draw here something. This is a box, we can call it a body. Either you are pushing it, you know pushing? Like you need to apply force, okay, you need to push it. Or pull. Pulling means you will hold and you will pull your side. So either push on a body or either pull on a body, both will be called as force only. So the definition is push or a pull on an object or on a body is called as force. So now you need to identify what is push and what is pull. I'll give you some examples. Throughout those examples, you need to say or you need to think whether that is push or pull. Okay? So what are examples? First, sipping juice, erasing blackboard. Okay, sipping juice and erasing blackboard. M magnet attracting rails. Fruits fallen. Hoisting a flag. These are several situations, students, please look into it. Sipping juice, erasing board, magnet attracting nails, fruits falling, hoisting a flag. Which action is a push and which action is pull? You need to think. I'll see. I hope you all got it. Sipping a juice. You have a glass, you are sipping. Okay. You are sipping juice from it. So what you are doing? You are exactly pulling. You are pulling the juice. Right? Next. Erasing a board. Let me erase you something. Suppose I want to erase. What is force? What I'll do? It is not about left or right. It is about I am applying force on front direction. And then I am doing. What I am doing? I am pushing. Then I am erasing. Right? I am erasing. So here, erasing a blackboard is also action called push. Magnet attracting nails. Students, if magnet is going towards nails, then what you will say? The nails are attracting magnet. That means they are pulling it. But mostly what will happen? The magnet will pull the nails. Here it is given magnet attracting nails means magnet is pulling the nails. Something which is comes towards you. Right? Something which is comes towards magnet. So it is pull. Then fruits falling. So fruits are falling. Why fruits are falling? Because gravity is pulling. Gravity is pulling, right? So gravity is pulling fruits. So this is the action of pulling. Hoisting a flag. Hoisting a flag. In January 26th, on our Republic Day, what happened? We hoisted our flag, national flag. Who did? Probably our correspondent sir did, right? Done that work, right? Okay. What did he do? What did he does? Kya kare the wo? He simply went, okay, and just pulled down the rope. After pulling down the rope, the flag hoisted. Yes, students. So these are the things which you need to see here. Pulling, pushing, pull, pull, pull. So which action is push, which action is pull, we have identified. And they all are showing us force. Right? I'm sorry if grammatically I made any mistake. But I hope you all got everything, whatever I spoke till now. In upcoming part, we will discuss about the types of force. Thank you.